it's completely wrong what they're doing.
Was the CAO aware that someone at the police department was fabricating documents?
She was told by me, yes.
I think it's a real shame. I think that the people involved have caused embarrassment to the department.
It was a cover-up at the Albuquerque Police Department that nobody noticed. Not commanders, deputy chiefs, the chief, and no one in the mayor's office.
There are facts that are absolutely misstated and the conclusions are completely flawed.
Beth Moore is a certified fraud examiner, retired police officer, private investigator, and former chair of the Civilian Oversight Board. She reviewed APD's case file.
I have a real problem with someone who's doing an investigation, mishandling and mischaracterizing the evidence, and essentially lying about what someone said. That's a huge problem.
The trouble began last summer after APD's third highest ranking officer, Chief of Staff John Ross, bought himself a $2,400 laptop computer. Then Chief Mike Geyer said the purchase was unauthorized and called for an internal affairs investigation. Following a two-month probe, police officials announced Ross's computer purchase was by the book.
An Albuquerque Police internal affairs investigation has cleared former Chief Geyer's Chief of Staff of any wrongdoing.
However, instead of exposing wrongdoing, APD covered it up. Internal affairs investigations are supposed to be impartial and based on evidence. At best, this investigation was bungled. At worst, it was intentionally whitewashed.
Exhibit number one, a memo from John Ross's assistant stating Chief of Staff Ross has approval to purchase an Apple laptop from the city's technology department and the mayor's chief administrative officer, Sarita Nair. In fact, John Ross did not have permission to buy that computer, even though APD investigators knew neither the tech department nor CAO Nair had authorized the computer purchase. They did not question the misrepresentations.
We did not find that there were any policies violated by that memo.
Commander Zach Cottrell heads up internal affairs.
Angela Langley, who wrote the memo, she lied. If she says that the technology department and the CAO approved the purchase and they didn't, then that's a lie, isn't it, sir?
The investigation did address the memo through several interviews of the department employees as well as city employees, and there was no violation of department policy found.
The authorization memo bears Chief Geyer's stamped approval.
Did you stamp your signature on the March 5th authorization memo?
No, Larry, I did not.
Did you authorize John Ross to purchase an Apple laptop?
No, I did not.
Chief Geyer's signature stamp was kept by his assistant, Paulette Diaz, in an unlocked desk drawer.
Did you stamp the chief's signature on the March 5th authorization memo?
No.
So when Internal Affairs asked you if you stamped the chief's signature on the memo, what did you say?
No, I did not stamp it.
Despite her denial, Internal Affairs investigators concluded, quote, a preponderance of evidence shows Paulette Diaz stamped that memo with the chief's signature stamp. Now, what is that evidence? Well, nowhere in the report are there any documents showing Diaz used the chief's stamp to authorize a computer purchase. You didn't authorize the computer, and you didn't sign the March 5th memo. So how would you characterize that piece of paper?
From a law enforcement perspective, it's a forgery.
The memo could be considered fraudulent. In my opinion, they did not look into whether or not this document or any of the other documents that were presented were false documents. So they did not appropriately investigate that aspect of the case.
When contacted by Internal Affairs, the city's technology chief, Brian Osterloh, said in an email he had no record of a request from John Ross to buy an Apple computer. However, APD's investigator misrepresented the email when he noted in the case file Osterloh, quote, could remember specifically approving the purchase.
I would say that it is a typographical error in the report, and it should have been caught.
IA investigators reference an email from procurement officer Jennifer Bradley, which they say confirmed the computer purchase did not violate procurement procedures. In fact, the email never mentioned John Ross or an Apple laptop. Despite clear evidence the computer purchase was unauthorized, APD Brass cleared John Ross of wrongdoing. Internal Affairs concluded, quote, the alleged misconduct did not occur.
Was this finding based on the evidence, in your opinion?
In my opinion, this finding is not consistent with the evidence. The evidence was actually misrepresented by the investigator.
Last fall, John Ross voluntarily surrendered the laptop computer. And there's more. After John Ross was accused of giving himself an unauthorized pay raise, Internal Affairs investigated. At issue is this memo, purportedly from Chief Geyer to Chief Administrative Officer Sarita Nair, requesting approval for the pay raise.
I approved the pay raise for Chief of Staff Ross based on a memo that I got from Mike Geyer.
How would you characterize that February 7th memo?
It was a fraudulent document. I did not create that memo. I did not initial. I never saw that memo. And yet it's portraying that I'm asking for approval from the CAO for that salary increase for John Ross.
It was determined that Mr. Geyer did not author that memo.
Who did?
The investigation did show by an interview with Mr. John Ross that he did write that memo.
If John Ross wrote the memo and not Geyer, would that have made a difference to you when you approved the pay raise?
Yeah. Mike Geyer had not directed that memo to be issued, then yes, that would have been a problem.
Even though the pay raise memo is an apparent forgery, its authenticity was not questioned by investigators. In fact, when IA submitted its final report to the chief's office, they stated the pay raise allegation wasn't even investigated.
How does this happen? I mean, if you investigated it, you said you didn't.
That is another typographical error. I will admit that.
Following a two-month investigation, Internal Affairs found John Ross committed a single minor procedural violation. By the time the file landed in the chief's office, Mike Geyer had been fired by the mayor. The IA report was reviewed by Commander Cottrell and two deputy chiefs. The mayor's office was briefed, and Chief Harold Medina issued a written reprimand. No one raised concerns about the flawed investigation. Chief Medina is now asking the Attorney General and the state auditor to investigate.
It is of concern that we make sure that all investigations have the integrity necessary.
You know, I'm very concerned, and we've asked the AG to look into it, and if there's any wrongdoing, I'll hold folks accountable.
John Ross retired last year. He did not respond to our request for comment.
Do you think you owe anybody any apologies?
I believe the investigation looked at every allegation that was brought forth by the complaint and that there were no major policy violations committed by any department employee.
I think that it's doing a disservice to both the community and the officers when you have an investigation like this that is completely not factual and not based on correct evidence.
Is this how the police department is supposed to work?
Not at all, Larry. I'm very disappointed and ashamed to be part of this particular case.
Murray Barker, KRQE News 13.